Welcome, everyone. Welcome, everyone. Can't hear. Test 1, 2. Welcome, everyone. No. Can you hear me? Welcome, everyone. I have a couple announcements before we begin the graduation ceremony. Please remain seated until you hear the orchestra play Pomp and Circumstance. Finally, please silence all electronic devices at this time. Thank you.
Please be seated. I would like to welcome family, friends, faculty, administration, members of the Downingtown Board of Education, Dr. Lenardi, and most excitingly, the 192 seniors of the class of 2022. I'm so honored to be here to welcome you all to tonight. This year, I've seen our class grow tenfold compared to the previous 3 years. This year, we left the confines of our screens. This year, we were reminded to not take things for granted, and so we energetically relished in friendships and memories. In this moment, the ability to celebrate with one another one final time is something that I know we can't and won't take for granted. Among us, we can say that we've made it. 4 years ago, we applied to STEM, eager to see the high school life that had dominated our TV screens. Obviously, our high school experience was definitely not like the movies. The main character getting dressed at 8 a.m., asking the girl to prom, the idea that somehow a mass text could be sent to every person in the school. Clearly, we've had bigger concerns than picking between basketball and music. Instead, we learned the infamous acronyms at STEM, such as the EEVVRPPF3, the art of minimizing your time stuck in parking lot traffic, proper no-co etiquette, the do's and don'ts of a class Instagram, and the formidable choice of cat or pickle. We are the Downingtown STEM Academy's 9th graduating class and part of the 141st Downingtown High School commencement ceremony. Tonight, we recognize the 192 seniors and their dedication to scholarship, community, athletics, performance, and much, much more. We are proud and grateful to recognize the family, faculty, friends who have supported us in reaching this milestone. But our time here was only the prequel. Here's to the next step forward. Lights, camera, action.
Good job, Troy. Good evening. Our first speaker this evening served as lead editor of our yearbook, has been involved in Alex's Lemonade Stand for many years. She's a member of our National Honor Society and serves on our Camathon Committee. She also has spent time working with our cultural equity team on the celebrations for Women's, Asian American, Pacific Islander, and Jewish Heritage Month events. Outside of school, she completed an internship at Boston's Children's Hospital, working on cancer research and completing her practicum with DSM, developing biomedical devices. In addition to all of this, she also prefers cats over pickles. This seems to be the new Beanie Baby for this generation. Families in the audience, maybe you'll understand that. Her favorite happens to be Gumbo the cat. Anyway, she and Gumbo will be attending Northeastern University studying chemical and bioengineering. Please welcome Sydney Bales.
Years, 720 school days, 60 cycles, one bulky backpack filled to the brim with papers and notebooks, one locker that was never used. 4 years of time writings while still trying to master the difference between tone and mood and point of view and perspective. 12 months of Zoom school with endless repetitions of, you're muted. Hours of battling the STEM parking lot, all while trying to avoid being posted on STEM bad parking. hundreds of late nights and even more early mornings, and who knows how many retakes and revisions. Now, it's time to breathe. I think we can all agree that we have faced many challenges over the last 4 years. These challenges could have defeated us, but we stand here today united and stronger than when we started, as individuals and as a class. Today is a day for us all to be together and revel in who we have become and what we have accomplished. For we are not defined by the number of challenges we have endured, but by the number of times we have been resilient in the face of these challenges. As the author Maya Angelou said, you may encounter many defeats, but you must not be defeated. In fact, it may be necessary to encounter the defeats so you can know who you are, what you can rise from, how you can still come out of it. And there we were, 15 days ago, Marsh Creek, May 23rd, the senior class together, undefeated, celebrating the end of the year, cramming in one more event to make up for lost time. We rented 15 boats and kayaks, played several rounds of volleyball and spikeball, met two lovely park rangers, and spent hours in the sun eating watermelon and relaxing. And here we are now. Every one of us is about to embark on our own unique journey. Although we will be scattered all around the world, one thing is for certain. We are all equipped to succeed in the path we take. We can overcome anything and are capable of using what we have learned to face challenges head on. 4 years, 720 school days, 60 cycles. This is all quantifiable, but we know there is so much more which cannot be measured. The memories we have shared, the bonds we have made between peers and teachers, and the gratitude we have for our friends and family for supporting us. So thank you. You supported us through the ups and downs. You were there for the late nights and the early mornings, on the receiving end of the tired and the stressful days, and a witness to the relentless practicing of speeches, presentations, and performance evaluations. It probably was not easy for you either, especially during the pandemic when everyone was trying to get accustomed to a new way of life. But thank you for sticking by us and supporting us in our journey. We are the class of 2022. We are strong. We are resilient. We are not muted. We are undoubtedly better versions of ourselves. And with these foundations in place, who knows what the next 4 years will bring? Thank you.
Every year, the Downtown Area High School Alumni Association presents a prestigious scholarship to one student from each high school in the district. This scholarship is presented to honor these selected students for showing commitment to their school and community through extracurricular activities and leadership roles. Founded over 130 years ago, the Downtown Area High School Alumni Association is the oldest continually operating alumni association in the country and continues to uphold education and scholarship. Our speaker today is a pillar of the Downtown community. Serving as the Vice President of the Alumni Association, she is a graduate of Downtown Senior High School and Westchester University. She currently teaches music at Downtown Area School District Elementary Schools. Please give a warm round of applause to Ms. Angela Baer.
Good evening. My name is Angela Baer, and I'm a Downtown teacher, parent, and board member of the Alumni Association. I'd like to congratulate all of the STEM graduates in the class of 2022 and wish you well in your future endeavors. If you move away, take a piece of what you've learned in Downtown with you and give back to others in your new community. If you decide to live in our area, join our fellow alumni be part of our good neighbor community, and help support the Downingtown students as they continue in our tradition of excellence. So what does our Alumni Association actually do? The Downingtown Area Alumni Association, as you heard, is recognized as one of the oldest active alumni associations in the nation, and it was founded in 1884. We sponsor your homecoming events, the Battle of the Brandywine, which is the annual East versus West football game, and the Downingtown High School Alumni Hall of Fame. We also grant a scholarship, which is in the amount of $2,500, to a graduate of each of the three high schools. The class of 2022 scholarship recipient is extraordinary. This student maintains a high GPA and participates in numerous activities such as the Movie Magic Club and the Downingtown West Marching Band and Indoor Drumline, just to name a few. He's the president of the STEM AV Club and plans to study audio music production in the fall at Lebanon Valley College. It's my honor to present the Downingtown Area Alumni Association Scholarship to Elliot Johnson.
We are blessed to live in a nation where freedom and liberty are fiercely protected. Many of us graduating today are 18, which means we are officially adults. And as adults, we have to make many choices regarding our future. Five of us have made an honorable and brave commitment to selflessly serve our country. We would like to recognize these students at this time, and we ask that you please hold your applause until directed. Benjamin Hardin, Army ROTC at Virginia Tech, Corps of Cadets, Senior Military College. Alexander Nguyen, Air Force ROTC, Detachment 730 at the University of Pittsburgh. Jacob Fick, Air Force ROTC at Penn State University. Mitchell Winiger, Navy ROTC at Penn State University. And Brendan Haughey, Army ROTC at Rochester Institute of Technology. We recognize these graduates today not only for their decision to serve our country in the United States Armed Forces, but also for their decision to do so with such conviction. Will the five of you please stand and remain standing? To those currently serving our country, and to all of those who have served, please stand with Benjamin, Alexander, Jacob, Mitchell, and Brendan, and be recognized for your service to our country. Thank you, and you may be seated. The Downingtown Area School District has a long-standing tradition of excellence. Each year, the staff that have served our district for 35 years are recognized. This year, we would like to acknowledge Jennifer L. Tawari for her 35 years of service to our Downingtown community. As a third grade teacher and building leader at Lineville Elementary, Ms. Tawari supports her student and school community by participating in the Lineville Singers, the Cultural Equity Leadership Team, and Read Across America. Ms. Tawari, please stand and be acknowledged. Thank you.
good evening. While we're celebrating the success of the class of 2022, it is equally important to acknowledge the faculty members who have guided us along the way to this very ceremony. This year, the National Honor Society Executive Committee has chosen to honor Mr. Eric Brown, a beloved physics teacher at STEM. The energy, engagement, and enthusiasm that Mr. Brown brings to the classroom truly deserves this honorable recognition. Mr. Brown began his journey at Penn State as an engineering student. After taking a semester off, he realized that his real passion was for teaching. So, he transferred to Westchester University, where he pursued and graduated with a degree in physics education. While at Westchester, he student taught at Downingtown East High School. Then, he substituted for a few years before bringing his knowledge and experience to STEM in 2014. Some of us have had the honor of having Mr. Brown as a teacher. I was not one of them. However, in my process of interviewing him, I realized just how much I, and most likely many of us, had missed out on. He has said that the students at STEM make his job easy. Mr. Brown loves talking about how the world works, especially waves for its connection to music. He is equally fond of talking about how proud he is of his students, watching them grow from ninth graders to young adults, ready to make a difference in the world. His students will say that Mr. Brown has taught them many important concepts in physics, like how every action has an equal and opposite reaction via Newton's third law, or how when in doubt, just remember that force equals the mass times acceleration during IB exams. But I think what will resonate the most with everyone here tonight is potential energy. Potential energy can be defined as the energy available to an object due to its location in a gravitational field. And by this very definition, we here today were brought up by our teachers to be holding on to the most potential energy we will ever have in our lives. Mr. Brown is no stranger to this at all, because in fact, every moment he had with every single student, whether it was in room 204, where the physics department now resides, or online through the Zoom Academy, or back in those mirrored walls of what is now a part of our gym, you could always find Mr. Brown at his desk, ready to answer any question, rearrange any equation, and help us grow to our fullest potential. And so, as we're seated here today, I would like to say to Mr. Brown, on behalf of the class of 2022, thank you for your mentorship, your devotion to our school and its students, and for encouraging the next chapter of our stories to be as impassioned as yours. Mr. Brown, will you please stand and be recognized? Thank you.
Good evening and congratulations, graduates. We are so proud of you. Our next speaker is the two-time president of STEM's chapter of the Technology Student Association and serves as vice chair of the Pennsylvania TSA. This student also participates in Downingtown speech and debate, and NHS has volunteered countless hours towards the Downingtown BAPS Temple and is the founder of Wizardry.edits, an Instagram sports edits page that has been mentioned by many acclaimed NFL stars. This project is particularly important to him as an avid Green Bay Packers fan. After graduation, he intends to major in biomedical engineering at the Schreyer Honors College at Penn State University, hoping to develop innovative solutions to biomedical needs, such as the development of artificial blood. Please welcome your 2022 prom king, Viraj Patel.
As renowned poet and activist Maya Angelou said, "You may encounter many defeats, but you must not be defeated. In fact, it may be necessary to encounter the defeats so you can know who you are, what you can rise from, how you can still come out of it. As we've learned, failure is an unavoidable aspect in our path. Let's take a moment to reflect on some of our struggles. We all remember how we fought the hardship of having only 5 Noko chairs at a table, right? Wait, let's think about it. Was it 5? 6? The round ones had 5, the rectangular ones had 6. I already forget. Or remember in freshman year how we didn't know how intimidating Ships of Purple would truly be? Luckily, when we entered the IB, our work ethic was so unmatched that we actually broke the record of IAs completed the night before. But were these truly struggles? Do they truly highlight defeat? We are graduating at a time when our world is dealing with many serious problems. COVID, global conflict. If there are more wheels than doors in the world, it's wheels, by the way. Yet, these problems will leave us with countless opportunities to persevere, such as creating a complex algorithm that calculates the different classifications of doors and wheels, something a STEM student would totally do. But maybe the most relatable experience of perseverance is how high school went by in a Zoom, literally. I think we can all agree that there's nothing quite as frightening as being in a breakout room waiting for someone to talk. As we continue into college and the future, we'll appreciate how much we persisted. We'll find the joy in interacting once again with professors and students in real life, and not just blank screens on a Zoom meeting where you can use the "my Wi-Fi isn't working" excuse and leave. Persistence allows us to have the courage to fight failure, to turn those cameras on. It enables us to have dreams. Well, except for the ones the night before our IB exams. I mean, they are a kind of a dream. Nightmares. What we've experienced at STEM is a group of people who persist through failure. The retake policies give us countless opportunities to develop our confidence, to try without the fear of failure. Collab rooms allowed us to work together to overcome the defeat of failing practice problems. Teachers were ready to answer our questions every day so we can try in the classroom without limitations. It's these support systems that help us embrace and overcome failure. As modern day influencer and professional artist, Sheik says, "Aim for the stars, shoot for the moon." Now, I want to ask, who are you? Maybe you're an athlete that may face future setbacks in your dream career. In the face of adversity, who are you? Maybe you're a student who needs to find a new passion after realizing that multivariable calculus isn't what you enjoy. Who are you then? Whoever you are, you will encounter changes in your path that shape your journey. But these aren't defeats. Rather, they're simply part of life. Deviations in an ever-changing path. So dream more, do more, and become more. Because that's what we've learned here at STEM. We may not be the smartest in the room, but we have experiences that help us persist through failure and rise from it. These experiences give us the courage to fight, manage our time, except during our IAs, and rise from failure. As we begin the next chapter, we must remember to fight hardship. Whenever defeat strikes, stand up, endure, and persist. Find laughter, and don't ever forget who we are, Downingtown STEM class of 2022. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. As a member of the Downingtown Music Program, I am both honored and proud to welcome our wonderful STEM Academy Orchestra and Choir. Ms. Stephanie Gonzalez has been our STEM Orchestra Director for 6 years, and under her guidance, our orchestra has grown into a talented group of young musicians. Her passion has supported each student along their musical journey here at STEM, helping them to become the wonderful orchestra we will hear from tonight. She has created a welcoming space for her students, showing her kindness through her personalized hat tradition for her seniors, and through the strong support she provides for students to pursue music beyond the classroom. This evening, the STEM Orchestra will play The Magical World of Pixar, arranged by Robert Longfield. Mr. Brian Lloyd has been the director of our choir since the very beginning of STEM. His welcoming classroom and positive attitude have given rise to the beautiful guitar strumming, soft melodies, and basement ballads that carry through the hallways of our school. His passion for music and teaching has allowed his students to foster their love of music. Under his guidance, the STEM choir has flourished, turning into a truly talented group of students I am proud to call my choir family. This evening, please welcome STEM's graduation band, Benjamin Harden, Oak Hu, Catherine McDonald, Anna Rourke, and Alara Fulmer, who will accompany the choir as they perform Taylor Swift's Long Live. At this time, I would like to invite the graduating senior members of our choir to please join Mr. Lloyd and his students. Thank you, everyone, and please enjoy tonight's performances.
Remember this moment. Our next speaker serves as a Sergeant at Arms for TSA, the website design chair for the Camathon Executive Committee, a freshman orientation leader, and the secretary treasurer for Student Council. He's a member of the National Honor Society and Downtown East Track, and has helped to establish both the Baskets for Seniors program, which donates gift baskets to senior homes during the holiday season, and an instructional T-ball program for young children. He will be attending the University of Illinois Urbana-Champaign to study physics, with aspirations of working with the world-renowned scientists at the Fermi Lab Particle Accelerator outside of Chicago in the pursuit of sustainable nuclear fusion. Apart from academics, he plans to play club baseball in college and continue his rather painful journey as a Philadelphia sports fan. Please welcome Aiden Junier.
Tell me if you've heard this one before. There was once a boy who had his whole life planned out before the beginning of eighth grade. As he sat at his desk, he watched the sunset out his window. His room was littered with little trinkets and math textbooks. At his feet, a golden retriever patiently waited to play outside. But he ignored her for now as the sunset faded and the tip of his pen danced across the to-do list entitled Goals. Even though the future was unwritten, he confidently envisioned the perfect grades, the clubs he would join in high school, the college he would attend, and the career he would eventually pursue. To achieve this vision, the boy felt like he needed to go to a particular high school, the Downingtown STEM Academy. He felt like if he worked hard in middle school, earned straight A's, established good relationships with teachers, and spent hours editing the essays as part of the application process, his hard work would pay off and he would be accepted into the school. But even with all this ambition, he forgot one key item. Life does not go according to plan. The next thing that happened was not part of the plan. He was waitlisted from the school. He was defeated. Despite this apparent failure, he quickly started to realize that life goes on, even in the midst of defeat. The list of goals is not permanent. These failures do not change the possibility of achieving those ultimate ambitions. Not even close. So, in this instance, I believe he started to see the necessity of defeat. I started to see the necessity of defeat. If you haven't figured it out, this boy is actually me. So you may be wondering, what's the point? Well, this type of experience isn't unique to me. I would venture to say that every person here has experienced defeat, failure, if you will. However, you cannot be entirely defeated by failure because it has a higher purpose altogether. You need to look past the defeat. And believe me, that's hard to do. But defeat is a necessary step to becoming the person you dream to be, to accomplish your lifelong goals and aspirations. If you take away nothing else, remember this. The true testament to your character is not the product of your failures, but instead composed of your responses to defeat. I'm speaking about this as if it is some new discovery. But the Downingtown STEM Academy class of 2022 knows this value of defeat. In fact, I used to believe that I didn't belong here at STEM because of my delayed acceptance. So I worked increasingly hard to propel myself past this apparent failure. What I didn't realize at the time is that this is exactly why I fit into this extraordinary class. I have never seen a collection of people so eager to excel in every aspect of their lives. Individually and together, we have accomplished so much. Never once have I seen our passions, our goals, that invigorating spark fade. I have only seen it expand into a blazing fire. Through every setback, obstacle, and defeat, both big and small, that desire to succeed only grew. That flame inextinguishable. But we are not alone in our accomplishments. It is also because of you, teachers, staff, friends, and family. Thank you for your dedication and commitment to our continued excellence. We will never forget all you've done to allow us to be here as graduates. So, class of 2022, I leave you with this. Let yourself be defeated, for it is necessary to use that defeat to burn brighter. Thank you.
That was great.
All right, we're almost there. As you heard, Maya Angelou once said something like this. You may encounter many defeats, but you must not be defeated. So, you know, as principal, I have to sometimes think about those things a little bit and reflect. And, you know, the idea of facing many defeats and never letting yourself be defeated is true. It's a must, but it's also very complex. Perhaps we need to clarify how I define a defeat and how I define a setback. To me, defeats are massive, earth-shattering, foundation-rocking. Defeats are something that we don't believe we can come back from or get past. They may demand a pause in our life and make you reevaluate your understanding of who you are and what is important. To me, setbacks are different. Setbacks, you know, they range from annoyances to hurdles to things that just get in the way every single day. For instance, a setback might include something like my first calc test. Freshman year in college, I was an engineering major. I knew it's what I wanted to do for years. I rarely questioned it. Calc 101 was one of those courses on a lengthy list of college courses that I would have to complete. No big deal, right? I was good at math. I liked it. First test came, boom, 35%. That was the result. I was shocked. I was scared. Never had that before. But I wasn't alone. Several people accomplished a similar score. The next few classes, fewer students appeared. As you'll see when you go to college, people just drop out of those classes. And after about a week, there wasn't nearly half as many as there were the week before. So, I really started to reevaluate if I was in the correct major. So I did what any STEM student would do. I studied for hours, and I did a retake. You believe that? See that? Retakes in college. How about that? The result? A 45%. We had growth. That's better, right? It is. That one hurt too. But it wasn't a defeat to me, it was a setback. It helped me with my humility, and it helped me with my work ethic. It established where and how I needed to grow. A setback that helped me learn how to learn. And I could use this, and I did. And I continue to, even till this day. Some examples of setbacks you may include for you is a year of IB assessments on Zoom while balancing home and school. Missing school because you were in quarantine and Mr. Sheehan came to your room, your classroom, right? So I had to add that. I didn't get that the first 12 times I read it. I also, maybe we had an early dismissal for this big storm that was coming right before a language assessment. 105 of you can appreciate that one, right? But the setbacks to me are based on your perspective. I can't explain your setbacks in detail, but I saw some of what you all went through, and I saw that you got through it. And I know with each setback, it will help you overcome your future challenges. You see, the second half of the quote is where we need to focus. With that, Maya Angelou also said, in fact, it may be necessary to encounter the defeats so you can know who you are, what you can rise from, and how you can still come out of it. Never letting ourselves be defeated is where we grow and where we learn and where we find our true selves. We gain determination, we seek new answers and new directions. We identified our real support systems. We acknowledge what's important to us. We learn to value and appreciate what we have and who we are. We have spent the past academic year getting back into a routine, building relationships, filling in some of those language and math gaps from the previous years, and getting to know our school all over again. And it was awesome to have everyone back this year. I saw you come back with smiles behind those masks. I could tell because your eyebrows were up, right? Some of you mastered the eyebrows without smiling, I think. But that's okay. That's okay. We saw when you took them off, right? You were once again eager and willing to participate in all the clubs and events as if we didn't miss a beat. You came roaring back with active engagement of student groups like Avitum, SAS, Best Buddies, Change Club, Society of Women's Engineers, Key Club, Cradles to Crayons, and of course, Spikeball Club. And many more that filled up our club days. This year, FBLA, HOSA, and TSA gained awards at the state and national levels, and once again, DECA took their successes internationally. After a two-year break, you raised over $56,000 for Cure for CAM. Nice job. Nice job. It was your interconnectedness and your relationships that helped you get through. Do not forget that. Do not forget the value of yourself, the value of connections. As you continue down whatever path you choose, you will face other defeats and setbacks. Remember, you learned how to overcome. Remember, you learned how to persevere. And remember, you, class of 2022, cannot be defeated. Congratulations. All right. Y'all ready? All right. Get your smiles on. All right. So if I could, Mrs. Kolb, could you please join me on the stage? And I would also like to invite members of our school board to come up to the stage and hand out diplomas to our graduates, please.
All right. Michelle Hong. Yeah! Alice Chen Liu. Yeah! Matthew Kieran Visaskis. Alexander Michael Nguyen. Kayla Marlene Nussbaumer. Shrey Dingra. Aparna Vagvala. Irene Ann Abraham. Isha Singh. Vibha Guru. Viraj Deepakumar Patel. Troy Marcus Ramaskal. Aiden Edward Junier. Sydney Catherine Bales.
Elliot Lewis Johnson. Anne Conley Johnson. Kenneth Yonghao Liang.
Anuru Sai Adebatla.
Gwendolyn Ann Locke.
Michael Joseph Allen.
Rhea Ann Latlakar. Kushi P. Amara. Jonathan David Liu.
Jillian Dixon Arismith.
Olivia Grace Lyons.
Sarah Asif.
Ajay Sai Maturla. Andrew Michael Babala. Grisha Kaur Maini.
Shobit Babu.
Mahathi Chowdhury Molina.
Samritha Balakrishnan.
Sriya Mangat.
Sabin Mateo Babachi. Alisa Nicole Marmaluk.
Morgan Elizabeth Berry.
Haley Ray Marchek.
Hannah Ray Rachel Benchmoor.
Simran Rakesh Mashru.
John Everett Benton. Hannah Michelle McGinty.
Shanti Bhaskar.
Aiden Casey McElroy.
William Lewis Blazik Jr.
Caitlin Joy McLean. Diana Lynn Bobko. Mara Rose Michaels.
Alejandra Marie Bogish.
Crystal Nardani Machoma.
Robert Michael Bowen.
Timothy James Millich.
Jay DiVincenzo Brady. Quinn Kathleen Morin.
Lauren Emily Bellata.
Andrew Charles Maurer.
Jeffrey August Burke.
Shrivasava Mukamala.
Victoria Paige Butler. Riley Alexander Nassor.
Joseph Victor Carey.
Ann Hoy Nguyen.
Jacob Andrew Shimon.
Grace Tiet Nguyen.
Shreya Chandra. Lucy McFarland Onderdonk.
Ewan Maxwell Chatton.
Pooja Parish Pandya.
Sagarika Chabra.
Ishant Vikrant Paranjabe.
Jackson Julius Kiapa. Dylan Bimal Patel.
Johannes Joshua Konzelman.
Vanshika Rasik Patel.
Sarah Rachel Crawford.
Brian Hunter Petrosky.
Hannah Rose Critchley. Maisie Grace Pavis.
Annika Krita Das.
Neela Jean Pfeiffer.
Shreesh Dasarkar.
Dean Angelo Paluch.
Stephen Christopher Dean.
Grace Caroline Paluch.
Stella Marie Defaba.
Nicole Dean Prendergast.
Cassidy Mary Denning.
Robert Vincent Presloyd.
Ethan Philip Dentner.
Gavin Sison Q.
Julia Caroline Dentner.
William James Quinn.
Kevin Dharmaraj.
Madhav Kashyap Sagar Raghavendra.
Arnav Dingra. No, Arnav! Nandita Chuddy Reddy.
Kaylee May Dortone.
Rhea Reggae.
Elise Morgan Duffy.
William Allen Rosetto.
Grace Claire Dunleavy. Brianna Christine Roth.
Samuel Alexander Elmore.
Kavish V. Sani.
Cole Richard Embleton.
Sydney Taya Schwager.
Andrew Michael Badgen.
Megan Elizabeth Sebi.
Jacob Tyler Fick.
Sophia Trinity Setlock.
Zachary Theodore Fidlon.
Siddhant Sharma.
Brendan John Flynn.
Luke Scott Shaw.
Zoe Elizabeth Fontecchio.
Savannah May Shaw.
Aiden Joseph Galdes.
Shannon Shee.
Safika Sesha Gunti.
Gobin Singh.
Drew Albert Gelling.
Sonali Singh.
Lucy Victoria Gensler.
Pranay Sivaraju.
Ava Cecilia Giampietro.
Marina Smith.
Eleni Kiriaki Gliptis.
Shankar Nilesh Soma.
Deeksha Goli.
Brian Adam Sotak.
Mohit Golapalli.
Alexandra Ashlyn Spatz.
Mara Gregor.
Caden Reed Jonathan Spiro.
Olivia Ann Gulish.
Alyssa Colleen Stauffer.
Curtis Dow Hankins.
Kyra Elizabeth Staz.
Benjamin Walker Harden.
Morgan Michelle Stevens.
Cooper Drake Harden.
Adam Joseph Stepke.
Reagan Olivia Harden.
Michael Prize Straub.
Jack Thomas Harper.
Adelaide Suchecki.
Alexia Florencio Harris.
Mateus Suchecki.
Brendan Patrick Hawhey.
Nicole Elizabeth Sudal.
Nadine Ilana Hirsch.
Hayden Thomas Taylor.
Grace Elaine Hollis.
Manuel Matthew Thomas.
Dhruv Vinay Hobate.
Maria Ann Thomas.
Basil Adnan Hussein.
Jacob Reed Toth.
Noella Ndip Xavier Edom.
Alexandra Elizabeth Tyner.
Aryan Rajesh Ingale.
Abhinav Verma.
Liam Walker Jackman.
Dev Vidya Jijalal.
Brianna Marie Jenkins.
Rohit Viparla.
Nathan Sebastian Jiang.
Heidi Catherine Vogt.
Shreya Naga Kakamani.
Matthew Scott Wagner.
Milan Venkat Saisharan Kankipati.
Allison Leslie Waite.
Nikita Sai Kanamuru.
Christopher Riley Walsh.
Siddhant Rajesh Karpe.
Hannah Rose West.
James Connor Kelly.
Kendall Shay Wheeler.
Lauren Catherine Kilfoy.
Brooke Michaela Wilford.
Akash Krishan.
Mitchell Waylon Weiniger.
Jenna Alma Kirkbashevich.
Sophia Wu.
Akshay Siva Kumar.
Brandon Zhou Yi.
Jacob Michael Ladin.
Aaron Rebecca Yoder.
Mehak Lakhani.
William Tang Zhu.
Caden Michael Lean.
Jared Avi Zeef.
Elijah Lewis.
Matthew Joseph Zincone.
Just like that. At this time, I would like to ask our educational leader, our superintendent, Dr. Emily Lenardi, to please join me at the podium. Dr. Lenardi, I present to you the class of 2022 of the Downingtown STEM Academy. As principal, I am certifying to you that this class has completed all Pennsylvania statutory requirements for successful completion of high school in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. If you would please confer graduation upon these 192 seniors.
Thank you, Principal Campbell. First, let me say that I am so very glad to be with you, and more to the point, I value being with you in person, graduates, families, friends, and my colleagues. Before conferring the diplomas, I'd like to offer my sincere and heartfelt congratulations to the class of 2022 and to all your loved ones, both near and far. Class of 2022, you are entering the intersection of our world's most prolific challenges, but also our greatest unimagined opportunities. So be intentional about moving through this nexus. Do not get paralyzed by the moment. Rather, think big and plan bold. I am confident that you are well equipped to embark on the future, on a future full of promise, and can navigate this world to make it a better place for all of us. To this end, your achievement in the future will lead back to those who helped you along the way, the parents and guardians who you count on to be by your side when needed, and also give you the space to grow. The faculty sitting up here who have given you extra time, perhaps lent a friendly ear, and who insisted you try something you thought you could never do. And finally, the friends who have shared in your high school travails, creating a bond that has withstood the test of time. There is an old saying, the fragrance stays on the hand that gives the rose. Graduates, I urge you to take time to give that rose, and before this day has come to an end, to say thank you to all those individuals who helped you get to this very night. Let gratitude guide your mindset and permeate those with whom you interact. Please know that we all join you in this celebration and wish you unending success and happiness in all you do. And now, without further ado, will all graduates please rise? By the power vested in me by the Downingtown Board of School Directors, in accordance with Pennsylvania School Code, the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, and the Department of Education, I hereby confer the academic degrees, declaring the class of 2022 as graduates of the Downingtown STEM Academy. Graduates, you may now turn your tassels. Seated.
To my fellow peers, here we are in our literal final moments of high school, swimming in these blue gowns and wearing these caps with the pristine and shiny 2022 attached to them, an emblem of our achievements throughout our 4 years here. Well, semi-4 years, because for us, we were challenged with the obstacle of being abruptly distanced from one another for a year and a half. But whether that distance was obscured by glass, was 6 feet in length, or was through the pixelated screens of our beloved Zoom calls, we persevered through it all. We emerged more unified, self-disciplined, and passionate. And so here we are, sitting together as one, reflecting on all the friendships we fostered and memories we made to last a lifetime. I can only anticipate what all of us will do in our futures, and I can only wish everyone the best of luck with all that you do and who you will become. Please join us now to commend the class of 2022 as we make our final mark on all of our hard work. Graduates, please stand. Downingtown STEM Academy, please lift your caps and remove your tassels. On the count of three, our bright futures begin. One, two, three!